poets and event producer from Philadelphia. And for the last 2 years, I've been working with Team Sunshine Performance Corporation to put on this event, the Society of Civil Discourse, which you all are going to get to experience tonight. I'm super excited to be here to do the Society of Civil Discourse, and I'm also excited to be here at summer camp because a friend of mine and I run a summer camp for adults, and so this is like a double dose of fun for me. And this is Alex.
Great. Jake is going to be the primary host for the evening. I'm going to step aside. I'm a director, so I like to hide and worry. I just wanted to say a little bit about Team Sunshine and about this event. Team Sunshine is a Philadelphia-based artist collective, ensemble, theater company, all of those. And we do two things. We do experimental ensemble-created theater, and we also do community gathering, interactive, social events. Everything we do is about bringing people together, and that it's not just about looking here, but looking at each other. A couple years ago, Jake came to us and was like, I have an idea for an event. And he said the word bullshitting, and we were like, yes, that was great. And then we made this thing. I'd love to talk to you about what we do, and but for now, I'm gonna step to the side.
Awesome. How many people know by show of hands that this is about to be an interactive event where you're expected to do things? Great.
Great stuff.
And the rest of you, I hope you're easily amenable to change. All right. So I would like to start the evening with a toast. So you can either raise a drink or just your hand to the sky. And I would like to make a toast to the verbose, the loquacious, the untruthful, the passionate, the deeply stubborn in their opinions, the blabbermouths, the talkers, the chatterboxes, the listeners who give us space to breathe. To all of you, cheers.
Cheers!
L'chaim, Shabbat Shalom, Zivuli, Allah something. The Society of Civil Discourse happens in two phases. The first part is interactive. The second part is a great debate with some amazing volunteers from the network. We're so happy that you guys are here. There are three rules here at the Society of Civil Discourse, okay? First rule, no looking things up. No looking things up. If I say Star Wars first came out in 2011, then Star Wars first came out in 2011. You cannot take out your phone. You cannot show me on Wikipedia the year that it came out. But you are permitted to debate passionately with me about the year that Star Wars came out. Okay, so rule number one, no looking things up. Okay, no looking things up. Rule number two, always hear your fellow society members out. Some people may say some controversial things. They may say that pudding is indeed a better thing to fill a swimming pool with than Jell-O. And you may find that repulsive. You need to allow them the time and space to make their point, to make their argument clearly without interruption. Sound good? So always hear your fellow members out. And the last one, which I will break multiple times this evening, is speak passionately, just not at great length. So hopefully all 80 of you will get a chance tonight to say something and be listened to. In order to make space for that, we ask that you not give us your greatest soliloquy or your filibuster that you have planned for your local town council meeting, but instead be passionate and short and succinct. Sound good? Say yeah?
Yeah!
Awesome. Let's give you guys a chance to get to know somebody you don't know, okay? So what we're gonna do in a second when I tell you is you're gonna stand up. I'm gonna sing a little song that goes like this. Mingle, 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 mingle. Stop! And while I sing that little song, you're gonna move around. You can move around like this if you want. Or you can just walk around. Find someone that you don't know. Find someone that you don't know. Introduce yourself. And tell them about the thing that you're passionate about today. I am passionate about my anklet that I found in bunk number 4. So passionate that I rolled up my pants legs to show off. So, everybody stand up, stand up. You're gonna find somebody you don't know, and you're gonna talk about the thing that you're passionate about today, and if you wanna sing along with me, you are welcome. Ready?
Mingle, mingle, mingle. Mingle, mingle, mingle. Mingle, mingle, mingle.
Stop! So here at the Society of Civil Discourse, there is no fourth wall, okay? There's no fourth wall. So we want to encourage some active listening, some audible affirmation. So if you hear something you like, you can say yes.
Yes!
Yes. You can say, mmm. You can snap your fingers in a ripple anyway. If you don't know how to snap your fingers, you can take two fingers and just clap them on your face. I'm from Philly, you can say word. I like that.
I like that.
So as people are on stage or when you're at one of your stations, give the people who are speaking some affirmation, some love with your voices, with your eye contact, with your nodding, with all that good stuff. Sound good?
Yeah.
Awesome. Great. So we're going to model our three stations. And then we're going to induct all of you into the Society of Civil Discourse. So, yes, you're all going to become official members. So there are three stations. There is the appreciation station, where you can appreciate things on your heart or suggestions that are in that little cardboard box. There is the hate station, where you can hate on things that are in your heart or things that are in that little box. And there is that debate station up there on the balcony. Yeah. Where you can debate things that are in that little box. And we're going to show you how all three of those stations work. So from our, let's start on a positive note. From our appreciation station, let's welcome up here, Sam. Hey. So I'm going to ask Sam to appreciate something. This is not rehearsed or pre-planned. And Sam is going to tell you why Sam loves this thing that I'm about to make up right now. Awesome. All right. So let's go with 60 watt light bulbs.
60 watt light bulbs. Love them.
Tell us why.
It's more than a 40 watt light bulb. But it's less than a 100 watt. I know that's in the middle. Well, it's between those two things. 80, I don't even know about. I don't have those. 60, it's just a good number. It's aesthetically pleasing, printed on the outside. Of the light bulb, yeah.
Grittiness that we all want to express right now. I did that wrong, didn't I?
I did.
Yeah.
Okay, that's why you're looking at me all strange. If you want to hate, you can join Sam at the hate race. Hey.
And
this is the
signal.
This is the signal. I
was going.
Say yes. Thank you. All right. So Claudia is going to show us the hateration station, even though Claudia is going to get the appreciation station. tell me why you hate Ithaca College.
Oh my goodness, I've never been there.
Yes.
I have a friend who works there, and I never see him. Yeah. Not because of the college, but we live in different states. But still.
I will definitely not
lean on the railing. All right, here we go. So this is how have a debate station that works. These two fine people will be facilitating the debate station up on the balcony. Okay, there are two rounds. There's a 30-second opening statements that each of them will get to make. And then there's the lightning round where they just make small, little, bite-sized amuse-bouche, like little bite-sized statements, okay? So the topic that I would like for you all to debate is, which would you rather sustain yourself on, subsist on, if you will, for the rest of your life, okay? Mm. Belly button lint or couch crumbs, okay? So you're going to be belly button lint for the rest of your life. You're going to be couch crumbs. 30 seconds, you have a bandana in your back pocket, you're gonna start, all right?
Couch crumbs, you all remember Twinkies, right? I bet you haven't eaten any of them in a while, but you still have them in your couches. So going into your couch, it's like archaeological, those of you who really are historical minded, really like to reclaim your roots. You can not only reclaim your roots theatrically, but you can also reclaim your roots behind the cushions of your couches. Okay. There's lots of history that we can talk about and that we can't talk about, but nonetheless, there is edible history and there is so much sensual history behind your cushions.
Alright, belly button lint. Maybe it sounds gross, but let's talk about it. It's easy access. Oh.
Archaeological exploration. It's time for the lightning round, starting on my right with belly button lint. One small point about belly button lint. Go.
So close.
Yes.
No, I got a remote control.
Yes.
Oh, you can do it anywhere.
True.
Halloween candy I haven't seen 25 years.
Yum.
Ooh, there might be some detergent in the fabrics to taste.
Febreze.
Licking the zipper of the cushion.
Wow. If you think couch cushion won this debate, lift up your couch cushion on the count of three, belly button lint or couch cushion. Ready? One, two, three. Couch cushion is the winner. All right. So that is the first half of our show. The second half of the show, we are going to come back here for a great debate. You see two empty seats on each side. That is because four of you are going to be recruited by either David, just wave to the people. David, nice. Or Danielle, wave to the people. So if they come up to you and say, hey, do you want to be in the great debate later? Say yes, definitely, absolutely, in the hands. All right, we're gonna have a 5-on-5 debate, debating things that don't matter. It is going to be really, really fun. Are you guys ready to be inducted into the society? Yeah! All right, repeat after me. I promise to converse passionately.
I promise to converse passionately.
Respectfully.
Respectfully.
Not beholden to the truth.
Not beholden to the truth.
But most importantly with concern.
But most importantly with concern.
For the health and wellness of the person with whom I am speaking.
For the health and wellness of the person with whom I am speaking.
Nice. With the station facilitators, please go to your stations and open them up for the people. There, the bar is back there if you would like to drink. Please enjoy all three stations at your leisure, however you would like. And at some point, I will yell something loud through the bullhorn to gather us all back into our seats. Sound good? Say yeah?
Yeah!
Oh, talk and listen! Talk and listen!
So clearly my vote did not change. It's the next.
Why?
The toilet that must do.
It's not going to if we don't see this. Okay.
All right, can I get a boo, Miller Lite?
Boo!
Ha ha ha!
cupcakes. Cereal. Down with the cupcakes.
Down!
Would you like to hear
something?
Alright. Something that makes something that makes
you
want to get the next
day
and
see
if you're a
singer
or
a
pet.
Freedom!
Oh,
cars. Why not send a probe to us? I want to be probed. Yeah. No, I want to be picked up by a Martian spaceship and brought to a sterile environment. I'm surrounded by beings that are vaguely human, but not really. And probed. You know, I don't want to have to try to do that. I want the probing to come to me.
Yeah. You can say I want the choice.
I want the choice.
Oh!
you're tired or you're sore.
About bug bites, and that is bed bugs. Let's go with alligator skin underwear. Okay, alligator skin underwear. let's go with one activity that you do when you're bored. One activity that you do when you're bored.
Where are the New York Times?
The New York Times.
Okay.
Go to a board meeting.
She said drowning.
Drowning.
Okay. In my ears.
Board games. Okay. Beating my ears. Okay. So we're gonna decide which has had a greater impact on human history, okay? Which has had a greater impact on human history? Alligator skin underwear or cleaning your ears while playing board games, okay? Cleaning your ears while playing board games. Which has had a greater impact on the course of human history, on the course of human history, okay? And so the way it's gonna work is we have 5 rounds. We have an opening statement from each team. We have an opening statement from each team. We have a personal story. What has your experience been with alligator skin underwear or cleaning your ears while playing board games, okay? Then we're gonna go with a statistician. Enough of the emotion. We want cold, hard facts. We want data. We want graphs, pie charts, percentages, polling data, blind placebo tested lab results. We want those things. Then in the 4th round, like any debate worth its weight in salt, the mime round. We have the mime round, and then finally we have a closing statement from each team. Okay, closing statement from each team. So on my left, Danielle has recruited 2 new team members. Would you like to introduce your 2 new team members?
Yes, my team members are Ella.
And Dave, could you please introduce your 2
team members? I would love to. My 2 team members here are Heather and Mark.
So we have the Q-tips arguing for that the with the in the clicking ears while playing board games. It's had a greater impact on human history, and we have the briefs arguing that alligator skin underwear has had a greater impact on human history. I'm gonna sit off to the side somewhere and maybe come and cut you off when your time is done. So please, could we have an opening statement from the Q-tips? Okay, can we have a moment for you guys to do that? All of you guys, what I want you to do, I saw the host do this out in California last week, and I want to steal it from him. So what I want everybody to do is, in your row, cross your arms, and with the person next to you, get into a thumb wrestling position. Q-tips. Welcome, Sam.
Yeah.
Yes. Yes, working. Since the dawn of time, people have been cleaning their ears and playing Monopoly. And really, when you combine the powerful esoteric traditions of these two pastimes, you can take over the world, the Monopoly world, and the actual world, if you play your cards right. Yeah, it's, you know, we've all heard of a poker face, but there's the lesser known and much more prestigious Monopoly ear.
I'm glad you began with painting a picture. You know, that's right. One should begin such momentous decisions by painting a picture. We are a visual people. But we didn't start that way, of course. There was a time we were animals that did not have eyes. We had not developed them with the power of evolution. Until one eyeless animal had an idea.
A crazy idea, maybe?
I don't know. I'm just a Homo sapiens wearing extraordinarily comfortable alligator suits. I can only speak from my experience, but I think when that eyeless animal decided to skin an alligator and place the dried out skin of that alligator around its nether regions, that was the moment life again. Let's move forward in time. Let's remember the horrible colonial legacy. Yeah, I'm gonna get real. I'm gonna get real. Of the English Empire. Until one man, and it's always just one man. It's history, right? Decided he couldn't take it anymore in a country called India. And even though he was a vegetarian, he still skinned that alligator. He didn't eat the meat. But Gandhi still placed that sexy as shit underwear on his body, and he brought down colonialism. Imagine five more examples. Even more emotionally moving than the rest.
Yeah!
Our openers have given us a broad picture, a broad context, an outline, if you will, for us to put our thoughts in. And next, it's time to go from the macro to the personal. It's time to go to the intimate. It's time to go with the conversational, if you will. I want to hear a personal story. So please, from the Q-tips, who are you setting up? David, for a personal story. David.
Yeah.
The great Chutes and Ladders incident of 1965 will always be burned in my memory. My little sister, Beelzebub, had just taken her turn. She handed the dice to my brother, Cooper. In a mystery artillery that rivaled the bullet that took a left turn when it killed President Kennedy. That dice went backwards. And hit poor Gooper in the ear. And lodged it. And if not for the sharp edges of that chutes and ladders board, Gooper would be dead. But now, he's one of the greatest Americans who ever lived. George Gooper Bush.
Thank you for grounding us in this day. from the briefs we'll be setting up. Danielle, please give us a personal story.
It was the year 1999.
Oh, yeah.
And I was vacationing in New Orleans.
Come on.
Hanging out on a swamp tour. And you know what swamp tours are like. You know, you're partying with your friends, walking a few bags, and whatever, right? Well, it was dusk.
Okay.
It was hard to see. Very hard to see. And, well, I perhaps had a little... And I fell overboard.
Oh,
in the swamp.
Oh,
and I knocked my head on a stone that was in the water. Out!
Oh,
my vision was clear. It spoke to me, because as I was floating in the water, and perhaps my friends were scrambling to save me, but for me what was going on was I was sinking down into the water. But something came and lifted me up. It was like it came from behind me and swooped me up. And I was like, what is this? I couldn't tell if I was asleep or awake, dreaming or not. But I was saved.
Wow.
Testify.
And in that moment of being swept up and lifted up out of the water, I took my hands and I felt around and I could feel the scaly, bumpy, hard, fleshy surface of that, I don't want to say thing, I want to say being, I want to say soul, that saved me from the water. In that moment, I had an epiphany, underwear that will save your life.
Yes.
Underwear that will protect you.
Oh,
underwear from an alligator skin.
To quickly transition out of personal. I think we're losing the forest for the branch. And we need the broad picture. We need more. We need data. We need data. There's something about numbers that I can say speaks to all of us in a really special way as theater artists. Now is the time when I ask that each of you bring your statistician to the stage. So please, Q-tips
Now, if I could please have your attention in the PowerPoint presentation here, if you look at line XXY, column 427, you see statistically, through the dawn of time, human beings have used games and gaming technologies in order to survive great crises. Dr. Jane McGonigal, UCLA professor, once wrote in her book, How Games Save Worlds, that it is through the use of gaming, in addition to hygienic cleanliness, especially the use of ear wax residue that saved particular civilizations. What went wrong with the Roman Empire? Does anybody know?
Ear wax.
They did not accumulate enough wax. Now, if you could please look at this pie chart here, you can see the proportion per nation, capital, and historical timeline, how many civilizations survived through the use of earwax or no earwax in addition to their gaming technology. Now, as you can tell, please switch to the next slide. In direct proportion to earwax and lack of earwax, we see an incline here. Yes, everybody sees this? Yes. And then, of course, a decline. So, ergo. Without the use of earwax, in combination with high-skilled gaming technology, in particular cultural constructs, civilization will crumble.
Thank you.
And from the briefs, a statistician, please, Ella!
So, we see on this pie chart right here, the percentage of people who use regular underwear and have problems with it.
Words cannot convey. That there's a deeper meaning, that there's a deeper level of communication. communication that we feel and see with each other yes. through the much respected, the very lucrative and profitable arts of mine. Mine is money. So please, from the heat tips, Tori!
Trivial Pursuit.
I can go on.
That's debatable. It hasn't been proven. Still doubt. Still question. Can we all circle? Need I say more? You know. I know.
Who knows?
All of us who know. We're there together.
Yes.
We know that what makes this country great, what makes you great. Earwax, board games.
Yeah.
And Claudia from the Briefs with your closing statement, please.
Games, playing games. But what I want to talk to you is not about what makes this country great. I want to talk to you about what makes this world. Yeah. My colleagues here have given you a lot of facts. You know, they've talked to you about very specific points in history, places where the brief has helped to make world history better. We've shared some pretty powerful and emotional stories of trauma and survival and entrepreneurship.
Yeah.
I think we all found very inspiring.
Yes.
And we also shared with you science.
Science.
Incontrovertible science. And I'm going to apologize on behalf of my colleague. But his point was so important to make to y'all that he had to whistle.
Oh!
And I do not think the whistle negates the truth of what he was saying.
People that live where you live, which I'm sure you can find. I'm going to invite Alex up on stage just so you can see the moment when a director stops worrying. Alex is going to be here all weekend. We would love to hear your feedback. There's a session on some other day that's not today, Sunday, to give us more structured and constructive feedback that we really, really, really appreciate. And I think that's it. Is that it? Awesome. So, here we go. You're voting between an outgoing director that you really respect and love. And a really talented and impressionable child.
Yeah.
while playing board games, one with one hand, you're going to clean your ears, and the other hand, checkmates. Okay, ready? On the count of three, ready? One, two, three. Checkmate!